My name is Eva Lisowski, and I'm a student at MIT in the Nuclear Science and Engineering Department. For nuclear engineering specifically, my interest kind of started in middle school when we were learning in eighth grade science class about all the various types of energy. I remember there was a survey at the end of the unit, like which energy is your favorite? I thought nuclear was really interesting because it was harder to imagine like where the power was coming from. The sun, you can see it. Coal, you know what it looks like. So I picked that because I was really interested in it. But then when we got the pullback, only 2% of the class picked nuclear as their favorite, and most people said that it was the most dangerous. That's the first time that I remember wanting to pursue learning about nuclear engineering, because I always questioned when people said something was bad or good. I always asked why, because I didn't just want to take things for face value. Right now, I'm taking a neutron physics class. There are many components that go into a reactor. There's like heat transfer, and there's like the fluids and how fluids behave in the reactor, and then there's the neutrons. Neutrons are the least, it's the hardest to conceptualize. So that is where my interest lies when it comes to nuclear engineering. In our homework assignment, we actually had to write up code that randomly generated how the neutrons were going to scatter or get absorbed inside the reactor, and then make a graph of it. To see the final product of that homework assignment, even though it's pretty basic, it made me really excited to, like, wow, I'm actually starting to get to a place where I'm not just learning about physics and math, but I'm actually like seeing what's going on inside a reactor. So producing that visual, that's helping me to like figure out my interests and like kind of figure out like what I might want to do in either industry or research as far as like neutron physics go in the reactor. I'm not really sure what I want to do yet. Right now I am in ROTC, the Reserve Officers Training Corps, and I'm in the Army branch. So I'm hoping to become an Army officer right after I graduate, and then maybe join the military intelligence branch of the Army. ROTC helps you learn to quickly identify what strengths other people might have, and then how to delegate tasks to them accordingly. That's something I really enjoy about ROTC, the opportunity to have that kind of learning experience. That's a little bit different from what I'm learning inside the classroom.